Hello, good day. This is Engineer De La Cruz and welcome to our video tutorial. So for today's video, we will solve the common engineering mechanics problems on the CE board. So these are the specific problems that I prepared. Okay, so without any further ado, let's start to solve these problems. So the first situation, the portable seat shown is braced by cable FG with permissible tension of 2100 newtons and the surfaces C, D, and E are frictionless. So the questions are calculate the safe load W that the seat can carry. Of course, bibibase natin ito sa allowable permissible tension, which is ito. And the second and the third question is very easy lang. Okay, it can be solved by equilibrium equations lang dito. Okay, so what's the first step? Okay, unahin natin yung overall system, yung free body diagram. Okay, look at this. So we have, since that is frictionless, the reactions at E and C are normal forces lang. So let's call this RE and let's call this RC. Okay, and let's solve this in terms of W muna. Okay, let's say summation moment about C, that should be zero for equilibrium. So we have this W will cause clockwise rotation. I mean, this RE will cause clockwise rotation about C. So that will be RE times 0.6 minus W. The moment arm is from here up to this point lang. Okay, so we have 0.6 minus 0.25. So expressing RE to W is 7 over 12 of W. Okay. Now, let's compute RC naman in terms of W. That should be summation of forces vertical should be 0. Okay, so we have RE, which is 7 over 12 W plus RC minus W. And of course, it will result to 5 over 12 of W lang. Okay, the complementary of RE. Okay, so distribute natin. Now, for question number 1 is calculate the safe load W. So there are two options to solve this. We can consider this one segment here or this another member here, the member ABC or the member DBE. It's up to you. But anyway, the same answer lang yung lalabas. Okay, but any of the two, we should calculate the reactions at this B muna sa taas. Okay, so isolate ko. Yun. Now, take note, we have here a pin support. So, dalawa yung reaction dito. And dito naman, that is a normal support lang dito. Okay? So, we have, of course, that will be the same dito. Okay? And dito rin, that will be the same of 5 over 12 of W. Because as you can see, if you take moment about this A, so the same lang yung ginagawa natin, the same lang yung ginawa natin from the first slide. Okay? And we have the horizontal component here, but as you can see, we don't have any horizontal external force dito. So, zero lang ito. Okay? Then, we will transmit these forces here dito sa ating members. Okay? So, magiging ganito yan. Action, reaction. Okay? Now, for me, gagamitin nyo na lang itong member DBE. Pwede rin dito sa member ABC. It's up to you. Okay? In this solution, gagawin ko yung member DBE. Okay, look at this. This one. Okay, this is the free body diagram on member DBE. And of course, ito yung tension. This cable will has tension dito. Let's call that T. Okay? Now, how can we solve this W? Take note, we have the unknown W dito and also dito. So, isang unknown lang yung matitira dapat. Okay, we should take moment about B. We should take moment about B. Bakit? Because if you take moment on the other points of this member, take note this B has reactions. That is also pin. We have the vertical and the horizontal reaction. Okay. Now, if you take moment about B, these two can be neglected. Ang matitirang unknown is ito lang. And this one. Okay? Okay. Summation moment about B must be 0. That will be 7 over 12 of W times 0.3, the moment arm that will cause clockwise rotation, then this one naman will also cause clockwise rotation about point B. Okay, plus 5 over 12 W times the moment arm. Of course, the moment arm is here up to this point. So it is also 0.3. Okay, half of 0.6. Now, this tension will cause clockwise rotation about point B. Okay, kaya minus yan. Minus 2100 times the moment arm is here, 0.2. So we have the answer here, 1400 newtons. That is for part 1. Okay, so actually ito lang yung medyo challenging sa problem na ito. These two, the preceding numbers is very easy na lang. Okay, look at this. Ibabalik natin. So, for number 2, if W is 1620 newtons, what is the reaction at D? So, of course, the reaction of D is the same dito. Pinakita natin sa free body diagram kanina. Okay, so for part 2, the reaction of D is just 5 over 12. Now, the W here is 1620. Okay, take note, this is from part 1. This one is for part 2, 1620. So, the answer is 675 newtons. And for part 3, if W is the same pa rin, what is the reaction at E? So, of course, ito lang yun, 7 over 12 of W. And W is 1620 newtons. So, we have 945 newtons. That is for part 3. Okay? Actually, may dinerive na formula dito, no? Kasi we can create a relationship between the W and the tension. But anyway, medyo para sa akin lang, no? Madali lang naman siyang isolve. So, no need to memorize that formula lang. Magdadagdag yan ng burden sa pag-memorize ng mga other formulas in the CE board. Okay, so situation 2. So, hindi ko alam ilang ulit na itong lumabas sa exam, but I'm sure na this is very common. Ibabalik-balik ito. Okay, so each of the two elastic rubber bands, these two of the slingshot shown, have an unstretched length of 180 millimeters. They are pulled back to the position shown. Ito. This is pulled back papuntang direction ito. Okay? The direction of P. Then, each rubber band has a stiffness of 50 newtons per meter. So, compute the tension in each rubber band. And what is the pulling force in newtons? This one, the P. Okay, so this is the isometric view, or what we call this. Basta, yan yung view na pinakita sa problem. So, let's look at this at a plane view dito sa itaas. Okay, for simplicity. So, for question number 1, the tension in each cable. So, by drawing the free body diagram, ito yung... the length of this rubber band dito is ito yung stretch length. Okay? Diba, nag-pull back na tayo dito. So, na-stretch na yung rubber band natin. So, yun. So, this length can be solved naman by trigonometry, diba? This is by Pythagorean theorem. And the free body diagram dito, if you look at this, ganito yan. So, we will be having a tension here. Let's call that T, which is ito yung hinahanap sa question number 1. And that can be solved by using this stiffness. Okay? Diba? If we have stiffness, the formula of stiffness is force, which in this case, that is the tension, divided by the deflection or the elongation. And as you can see, we have initially unstretched length, and pag na-stretch na yan, meaning may elongation. So we can solve the elongation first, then we can compute the tension na. Okay, so solving for the elongation, take note this is, let's say this is angle theta, and we can solve that by arctan of opposite over adjacent. Okay, so we have 6.34 degrees. Now, calculating the deflection on each rubber band, that can we can say that LS minus the original length, which is 180 millimeters. And as you can see, LS can be solved by Pythagorean theorem. So, we can have this square root of 450 squared plus 50 squared minus the original length is 180. So the elongation of each cable is 272.77 meters. Okay, now, take note that the constant or the stiffness of a spring or any material, the stiffness is given by this formula, the force divided by the deflection. In this case, that is the tension force. Okay, so as you can see, we can solve the tension here because we have the K and the elongation. Okay, so cross multiply. So K here is 50 newtons per millimeter. So gawin per meters. So kinonvert natin ito by millimeters. Okay, divided by 1000, multiply by the elongation. So we have the answer, 13.64 newtons. That is for part 1. Okay, sobrang easy lang, no? Now, what is the pulling force P in newtons? Well, that can be solved by equilibrium equation, by summation of moment. I mean, the summation of forces horizontal. Okay, so what are the horizontal forces involved in this joint? So that is the horizontal component of T, of course, and this P lang. So that will be T. The horizontal component of T is cosine 6.34 degrees. Take note, dalawa ito, so multiply by 2, then minus P. Okay, and we have T here, 13.64. Ayun, cosine of, just bring down this equation here. And we have the answer P, 27.11 newtons. Okay, so that's it. Very easy na. Actually, we have another option here. Take note, this is a concurrent force. The forces meet on one point lang, so we can use the force polygon. And of course, tatlong forces lang to, so medyo mas madali siya. Okay, ganito yan. So another option lang to, ha? It's up to you, ano yung gagamitin mo. Okay, so take note, this T is, what we call this? We have this angle theta with the horizontal, and of course, dito rin, angle theta. Okay, and if this is angle theta and we have this triangle, this remaining angle is 180 minus 2 of theta, or we have 167.32 degrees. Now, as you can see, we have the value of T and the unknown is P. By sine law, P over the sine of the opposite angle, which is ito, 167.32, is equals to T divided by the opposite angle, sine of the opposite angle, theta. Okay, so substitute, cross multiply natin to. So T is 13.64 and we have these answers. The same sa ginawa natin. Okay, so that's it. So thank you for listening and hope you would like to see more on my videos, upcoming videos. Okay, thank you for watching and bye-bye.